purpose is in Christ and pursue it passionately so that together we can grow spiritually.
Absolutely. And beyond that, today we do have a cause, yes, the Keep a Girl in School program. Exactly. And we've encouraged every lady who showed up to come with pack of sanitary towels. And exactly, that's because our sisters who are much younger in different parts of the country sometimes do not go to school, yeah, when it's that time of the month,
that's
because
true,
they do not have the sanitary towels that, yes, they need for that. So if you're watching online and are wondering how it is you can support that cause,
yeah,
I know that there's going to be a slide with the information,
yeah,
with a number that you can send mobile money to. But as well, if you want to bring it in person, you can drop it at downtown.
Downtown,
we do have an office right there.
Any celebration point,
and let them know this is for Keep a Girl in School.
Exactly.
Auntie Martha, there's so much happening
there's
around
so
here.
There's so much more, and there's something exciting going to happen there.
On the
so
inside.
What do we do?
We're about to go inside to join the ladies. But if you can still come through and join us physically for this, it's going to be amazing. We'd love to encourage you. But right now, we're about to turn in and go join the ladies for some interactive fun,
yeah,
some worship.
Yeah.
There's going to be a medical a panel later. There's,
yes,
a medical camp happening,
yes,
right here. There's nyama choma. There's food. We're careful because there's
food. What are we waiting for, ladies?
Yes.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Happy
inside
Women's
and
Day.
Enjoy it.
May my prayer like incense rise before you. The lifting of my hands a sacrifice. Oh Lord Jesus, turn your eyes upon me, for I know there is mercy in your
sight.
Stand on my heritage forever. My heart is set on keeping your decree. Please still my anxious urge toward rebellion.
To welcome you this morning. We're so excited that you could come. And for our online families, ladies watching out there, I know there are some guys who are probably sitting with their sisters and wives trying to check out what we're doing in here. We welcome you too. We're so happy that you could join us. So welcome, welcome, welcome. It's going to be a beautiful time. And one thing we'd like to ask you to do is to raise up your expectation.
Yes.
Because we know for sure that Jesus would like to do something beautiful,
yes,
in our lives, with our lives, for the glory of his name. Amen? So I hope that you're going to be in that place just with your arms open, asking the Savior what he's going to drop in here. And whatever he puts in here, run with it and do whatever he asks you to do. Amen? You are so welcome. We're so happy to have you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Jackie. And yes, happy Women's Day. Tell someone next to you, happy Women's Day. Happy Women's Day, Jackie. And if you're online, just go ahead, type it in and wish a sister a happy Women's Day. How many of us are glad that you're a woman?
I am.
I'm pretty glad I am a woman, amen? Yes, we are. This day has just started. In fact, hasn't yet started. We are just about to start this day. Yes. So I hope you're not calling home trying to find out what food they are cooking. Leave them. If they starve today, let them fast. You feast. Today is our day to have fun. Tell your neighbor, please be here and have fun. Be present. You leave the people at home alone. Keep the phone busy. Just be here. Are we ready for that? Yes? I mean, we couldn't start before dedicating this day to the Lord and just giving Him thanks for today. Shall we pray together?
Yes.
Lord, we are so thankful that we are women. We are so thankful for your love and kindness towards us, Lord. We're thankful for the opportunity to gather here and just celebrate being women. Now we ask that, Lord, you will be with us as we have so much fun. Thank you for the weather that's already good. It's going to stay good the whole day. We pray for our sisters that are still trying to make their way here. Help them through the traffic, that they will be here and be a part of the fun. Thank you for the ones tuning in online. Thank you for all that you have in store for us today. We thank you, Lord, and we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Mrs. Ogwal.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Ogwal Jr.
Yeah, she likes to rub that in because she...
I think we need to introduce ourselves. We've not done that.
Yes.
Are you my sister? Because we have the same last
name. By osmosis, but you introduce yourself.
Well, my name is Jacqueline Rachel Ogwal, and I am a member of Watoto Church Weyogere. So, let's simply put it this way. I am your host. And you are in very capable hands. If you need to know where the toilets are, look for Jackie Ogwal. If you need to know where to find food to eat, look for Jackie Ogwal. Whatever, manya medical camp, you just say, I want Jackie Ogwal. They will point to, I am the chief volunteer today to make sure that you are very comfortable. So sit, relax, and enjoy this beautiful Weyogere structure. Amen? Good. So who are you?
Let's give it up for this chief volunteer, chief host, chief everything. If you've seen all the beautiful ladies in black waiting on you, she's the chief waitress for the day. Thank you, Jackie, for hosting us. My name is Maria Ogwal, and I come all the way from Watoto Church, Kansanga. It's an absolute joy to be here today. I wouldn't want to be anywhere else today, seriously. So it's an honor to be here and to see all of you ladies. Are you ready for some fun? Already? Yeah? Yeah? Oh. Jackie, even as people walk in,
yes.
There is, you first kusimba wakati, plant a stick there.
I have planted
plant
it.
A stick there. I'll tell you something later.
I have put it.
But before we continue, there is this psalm that has been on my mind. Psalm 103.
I love it.
I just want us to read the first 5 verses of that psalm, and then we talk through it a bit, just a bit before we get started. So if you have your iPhone, iSomething, or hard Bible, just open your Bible to Psalm 103. It's actually on the screen. And you can read along with me. It says, praise the Lord, all my soul. All my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases? Who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases? Who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion? Who's that? Yes, who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles? Who does that? It is Jesus. So he really deserves praise. Amen?
Amen.
Now I'm going to skip and go to just a few verses there. Verse 11. If you can just give me verse 11. It says,
For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, meaning those two are not planning on meeting anytime soon. The east and the west are not planning to meet. But as far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. Come on. Come on. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jackie, mm-hmm. Aren't you glad that your sins are not displayed on a screen somewhere for that day?
You know, I have thought about that, thinking if everything I do every Sunday when I'm walking into church, the Lord highlights for everyone to see, honestly, I would not be in this room right now.
Neither would I. So if you are glad that God is not displaying how you quarreled last night looking for monochrome, how you fight with, if you're glad that it doesn't display what you're thinking even now, come on, if you're glad that it doesn't display your sin, it takes it from the east to the west, then just go ahead and give God a big, let's just give God a big hand of praise in this place. Come on, ladies. Yes. Awesome.
Yeah.
Yaki. You even just look at the stage on both sides.
The choir in itself speaks.
Monochrome.
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 Ah, that word has tortured us since it was released.
Tell me.
Now, I have seen memes, monochrome memes, makeup memes, even goats. I've seen one of a goat with monochrome on it. Ladies have been busy. Not only with their legs and eyes, but even in the mind. Monochrome. What is monochrome?
Wait, I saw the one of the mind. Someone. Uh-huh. I woke up to it. Can't sanga people get saved? I saw one on the page this morning. Someone posted the head.
Just the head.
Just the head with no hair. Mm. And then there was a writing. What are you thinking about? And then they showed in the head one word, monochrome, with the face very sad. What? This person had worked hard finding monochrome. So let's clap for yourselves for working hard to find monochrome. You are all chromed up this morning.
Honestly, ladies went all out. Now, on our Boyogere Sisterhood page, never seen such conversations. I mean, people are looking for hearts. Actually, one asked a question. Now, ladies, are we supposed to monochrome just the top or inside? Someone said, the bra must monochrome. Everything from inside out, it must be monochrome. So, I am very sure, thank God, we don't have a swimming pool. Because if we were to say we strip and go swim, I am almost sure you'd see monochrome everywhere. Because the ladies have outdone themselves.
Clap for yourselves, ladies. On that note, we need volunteers.
Oh, yeah.
Who feel like I have chromed my day. What is monochrome again?
Same color, but in different shades.
Same color, different shades. Yes. Now, you run to the stage. Just pick one volunteer.
From each section.
Just come. I just want to confirm. If you feel like you can, you just run to the stage. Come. Just come.
And as the ladies come, we have an announcement here. Car number UBM165B Toyota Vitz, please. Go check on your car. You left it open. UBM165B. You left your car open. Please go take care of it.
Okay, now these are enough. These are enough. Wonderful. Oh, let's clap for them. You better be sure you're in monochrome as you stand here.
Ay. Whoa.
Hey, these are enough.
Okay, now. We have arrived. My goodness.
Wonderful.
Okay, this is serious. Mm. Ladies, you look amazing. Like, you have really... Ninga the hair. I see some hair in monochrome right here. We even have one whose hair is monochrome. That is very serious. We have really outdone ourselves. You look lovely.
What are we doing here?
I think we should handle...
Why did you call us?
Especially
me. Am I
me.
The one who called or you the one who called?
Yeah?
Who called the ladies?
It is you.
Me?
Yeah.
Okay. It's okay. So now that you are here, you are going to dance. We said monochrome is one what? One color, different shades. You have showed up. You're going to dance. And this is how you're going to do it. you're going to find a wolf dancing the one stroke because mono is one.
Yes.
So if you decide to move your right hand, make sure
remove
the left hand is not moving.
Only this.
So whatever you do, you first think about it quickly, quickly. The audience is going to be like, you go away if you're dancing with it, you choose.
I tell you, it has
you
to be
talk
a
amongst yourself.
Move,
someone should lead this group and just agree. Are we dancing to the left? Are we dancing to the right? You have a minute, a second. In fact,
choose a dance leader.
Choose a leader. You go one side, it is monochrome.
Are you the lead? You talk.
We're going
talk
to ask
with
your music. Happy
we
nice
have a
music.
Leader here. Ladies, we're all going to follow this leader. She's volunteered. So whatever she tells you to dance, that is it. Mono dance,
mono
I think
dance.
We'll call it.
DJ, are we ready?
Is he playing
have
mono music
mono.
Also?
Mono
music. Give us mono music. It needs to be serious, though.
You're sure you've talked through? You know which side you're going. Choose one side.
Hey,
hey, hey. Uh-huh. I'm a soldier at a battle field, waiting to hear the voice of my commander. Oh, Jesus, if you call.
Let's give it up for the ladies.
Yeah.
Did they give
yes.
us a mono dance? Hey, you are very kind. Did they? Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. The voters have said you did a very good job. So as you exit, there's a beautiful lady called Tina over there. She has a gift for you. You know, Women's Day is for just celebrating.
Hey,
so thank you so much.
But
enjoy
I think
the
they should walk modeling
what,
as well.
Please,
model. You don't just walk off the stage just like that.
In monochrome, moreover.
Yeah, modochrome.
They should modochrome off the stage.
We're chroming today.
Today, that's
everything.
It. Chroming.
Yeah.
No wonder there's only one God.
Thank God, mono God.
He's a mono God.
Only him. Everything.
You are clever. That's one of your problems. Okay. Jackie.
Yes.
Since I'm in the mood to have fun, I have one more.
Take it away.
Do you know?
Mm-hmm.
There are these riddles I came across that are so much fun.
Please tell us.
I want to see which side of the auditorium is very alert. We have riddles. Eh? We are going to ask questions. And you have probably quizzes that you can find.
I think I have some on my
phone. Are we ready for this, ladies? Even online, if you're online, this is your chance to win a gift. Someone is busy monitoring. So if you get it right, they will pick you up. They'll let us know and you will have a gift. You come and pick it at Watoto Church. So ladies, get ready. Are you ready? This is how it goes. It's very easy. I can ask something like, what did Adam say on the day before Christmas? Isn't that very easy?
What did he say? I think let's ask the ladies.
What did Adam say? The day before Christmas. It's Christmas time, okay?
There's a hand right there.
He said, Happy Christmas Eve. What else did he say? She's very close to the answer. Huh? It's monochrome. Also you. No.
There's one there.
It's Christmas Eve. Yes, clap for her.
It's Christmas Eve.
Isn't that very
Eve.
Easy? Mm-hmm. Yes? Now, if you think these things are easy, just come to the stage. Just come. I will say, okay, those are enough. Just come. They are very easy riddles. You have refused. Wamma online, get ready to win. Okay, we are now just going to ask randomly, and if you get it, you get it. Jack, if you have one, you ask. Mm-hmm. Are we ready?
Uh-huh.
Who was the best mathematician in the Bible?
Solomon, no.
Matthew, no. One more try. Elijah, no. One more. Noah. Okay. No. One more answer.
Joseph.
How can Joseph be a mathematician with all the colored things he had on him? But you have tried.
Jesus. They said Jesus.
Can I give you the answer? Because it has
given us.
It is the one who wrote the book of Numbers. Can you write the book of Numbers without being a mathematician? Also you.
But who wrote the book of Numbers?
The
do
person
they know?
Who wrote.
Who?
Moses.
Hey, you know. Okay. We should probably ask an easy
you
one.
You ask an easy
Since
one.
Since we're talking about Moses, who was Moses' mom?
Oh.
Her name. Anyone? Yes, lady in red. Who? Miriam was Moses' sister, the mother. Oh, yes, Jochebed, we have a correct answer right there.
Oh, lovely, lovely. Mm-hmm. Oh, some ladies reread their Bibles.
They read the Bible.
This is how you know. Now, there's this one. When is insurance first mentioned in the Bible? Online, do you have the answer yet? Online, when is insurance first mentioned in the Bible?
But do you know Maria? You know?
Yeah?
Who needed insurance?
I was there.
You oh, you read know. The Bible. Yes. No.
No one, the flood, that is when insurance first mentioned. You are almost...
Close to the answer. Eh?
Close to the answer, but a little bit far. But let's try again. Joseph's time.
There's a hand that way.
First Timothy. What did they say? It's a long one. 1 Timothy 5:8.
What does
1
Timothy
say? She has given us.
Now you're giving us a challenge. You answer your
parables.
Question. Why are you asking us the question again?
This one, if you get it, I give you a gift. Ah, there's an answer there. Yeah?
Where? What is it? To do what to our loved ones? To pray for them? No, but that's not the answer.
But I also didn't ask what is insurance.
First, say it properly. I think
the question was, when is insurance first mentioned in the Bible?
When is,
not
insurance,
what is insurance
first mentioned? Exodus 21:12. That's why I said Bible.
Riddles, you don't overthink. Riddles, the answers are right there. Now I have to give you the answer.
You tell us.
I tell you.
You tell us.
When Adam and Eve needed insurance, they needed coverage. They needed coverage. So
that's
the
when insurance is made.
Because at first they were okay, until things became other, like we need coverage. Where are you? I am hiding. Why? I am what?
I am uninsured.
So?
I wonder which insurance company they went to. No, it was the Lord. Not UAP, Manya, what? ICEA.
Now this one, they are going to get it. Especially, you know, there are some bishops' children in this house. They might get this one if we are raised by a bishop, by a father. But somehow you might know this answer.
Pickers.
Okay? Yeah, the pickers.
Mm-hmm.
Why is a preacher's favorite breakfast donuts? This one they know. They know. Let's see.
Because it is old.
I knew it. I told you when someone has been raised in a pastor's house. Now, Kayla has already told us what Aunt Martha eats at home. She knows the answer, right? Clap for Kayla.
It is holy.
Yes, she said they like donuts because they are holy. And no pastors like holy things. Hmm? Don't give them food. So because donuts have
holy.
They prefer to have donuts. So what's for breakfast? Donuts. What's donuts?
Donuts.
When they invent something else which is holy, they will eat it. Clap for Kayla once again. Kayla, you have a gift. One more. Yaki, do you have one more for us?
Let's go to a quiz. And this quiz is about women. So I want to know if the women know women in the Bible. So I'll probably do two. We do an easier one and maybe a hard one. How's that?
Sounds good.
Okay, so ladies, who was the woman that hid two spies under some piles of... Hey! Okay, everyone! Jonab? Rahab, is that what you said? You clap for yourselves. You're very clever. Okay, let me see if we get this one. Who was the woman? These ones, they're going to get it. Okay. Who was the woman that prophesied to Barak that he would win the battle, but the victory would be?
But these people overread their Bible. Don't. Ashir is there. She already knows the answer. Look this side. Who? This one. Check this side.
Hey, do. Near this side. Woman. Answer. Who? Deborah.
They
have outdone us.
She knows the answer. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they have
give
outdone
them one more, Lucy. Just one more.
Now I need to look for... I think this one they want to know. Who was the woman that drove a tent peg through the skull of Sisera?
They know that one. You don't give the answer. Keep quiet.
Who?
Daniel.
Maria, I think it's very simple. We need to conclude. The women read their Bibles, and that is a good thing.
They are reading their
you
Bible.
Soak yourselves in the word. Because
clap
you seem to know everything.
They know them.
Give us
they
another
should clap
piece.
For themselves.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
You clap for yourselves. You are doing so well. You know what? Let's go back to the riddles. Those ones, they
were a bit tough.
They are overthinking because they are reading the Bible a lot.
Yeah.
So we ask them the easy ones. Why can't a Christian be a bad person?
They're going to give us logical answers.
Auntie, that's the whole point. You don't have to be very logical on this one.
Mm-hmm.
Because Christ died. She's very close to the answer.
They have Christ. They have Christ.
They are very close. You keep, by the way, you are along
keep
the
thinking.
Path. Keep thinking. Because God is holy and we ought to be holy like him. That's very close. Online, are we getting some answers online?
Any online answers?
By the way, you are very close. Christ died. The answer
Christ
is around
died?
There. Christ, like, that person is almost at the door of the answer.
They are at the door.
There's another answer there. A little louder, my dear. Because Christians,
we are what? Oh, we are righteous in Christ. Is that the answer?
They are close, you know.
You just tell us. Even me, I want
listen,
to
listen. Recently,
mm-hmm.
I had no memes can be very funny. So someone wrote and the teacher was asking whether it is increasing
or
decreasing.
Yes.
And then the answer was?
What's the answer?
Increasing. Why is it increasing, decreasing? Increasing. That is now what is happening with these answers. Oh, Jesus Christ.
You don't know if they are saying increasing or Jesus
Christ.
Yes.
Died what? Resurrected Jesus. That's the problem. Now, okay, I'm going to give you this one. It is because it is God who made us. And everything he made is? Everything
good.
He made is
good.
Good.
So because God made us, we are good.
We are his creation.
So
he sat
good.
Back and said, wow.
It is good.
Everything I have made is so good. So if you walked into this place feeling like you're not worthy of God's love, he did not make anything fake.
No.
Everything he made is good. And he sees you with the same value. He saw you when he created you. Yeah. He still has that same value on each and every one of us. So rest assured that all he made is good, and you are one of his good creations. Mm-hmm. Amen. Are you having fun so far? Now get ready. We have some more, but for later. Now these ones will be for winning. That was just warming up. And we have seen, you know, your Bible. We are going to go and think of other things in the Bible to see if you really read. You dig deep as you read, okay?
Yeah. So, our time is almost up.
It is.
The pastor's wives. Mm. Don't you think it would be a good idea if they also came and showcased their monocle?
I told you you were clever.
And
I told
put
you
some to... dust moves.
Yaki, I knew you were clever.
Ladies, what do you think? Because we have a whole minute for the pastor. There is the pastor's wives, eh?
But pray for us after we are going to be killed.
Pastor's wives. Okay, I know some who like to dance. So we are, please come.
Yeah, you've spoiled it.
Let's clap for them.
Yes,
they are the initiators of Monochrome.
Yeah.
Please come. Our pastor's wife from downtown is in the house. We have a pastor's wife from Lubowa in the house. We have a pastor's wife from Chengera in the, and let's see if they are going to be rebellious. Ladies, well, let's clap for them until they get here. Our pastors, Ladies. Woo!
Woo! Yaki, I want to declare now that I wasn't a part of this violence right from the beginning.
Eh.
You started your violence. Be ready for it. Let's clap for our pastor's wives.
We shall start this.
Yes. Okay. Oh, and then comes the Shiloh.
Team, please give us a song. A nice song that these ladies can dance
can
to.
Can walk on to. Walk off. You forgive
maybe
them.
Maybe they will walk off it.
They
now you've
off.
Already come.
Yes.
They will mono off.
Yes. Wonderful.
They are all coming. So let's wait for the team to give us a song. We
DJ,
are taking it
ready.
Down.
I'm the MC.
DJ,
Maria.
We are ready for
Maria,
only 1 second. Go for it.
We are being ambushed that we also need to join
the
line.
We are the MCs. We are the ones with the mic.
You represent from the end. I'll represent from this side. Are we ready with a good song, Tim? Please, pull a number.
A number for us to get off the stage. I'm done. Don't know on Naga here.
We are done.
Are we ready to worship the Lord? There's only joy in the house of the Lord, okay? Yeah? So make yourself comfortable. Yeah? And after this countdown, let's get ready to give praise to the one and only King we have come to exalt.
Amen. Thank you, ladies.
join us in this song. It's new, but we can sing together. Amen. If you can, you can sing, but if you want to stand, it's all right as well.
I'm not forsaken, never alone. The God of heaven calls me his own. He's not just seated upon the throne. I know he's right here inside my home. I've got a treasure here in my heart, and in my weakness it won't depart. I have a Savior who will abide. He's not just with me, he lives inside. Just go as Daniel lived, our God will bring you out. Then he will testify, he shuts the lion's mouth. Go as those Hebrew boys, if you stick by your side, they will identify the fourth man in the fight. They'll tell you, oh, he's in the room. Yeah. Oh, he's in the room. I've got a treasure here in my heart.
Yeah.
And let's celebrate the big God who is awesome. And he's in this place. Come on.
Let us pray. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Let everything.
Let everything.
Hey.
Let us pray. Praise the Lord.
We say.
Praise the Lord.
A praise in the valley. A praise on the mountain. A praise when I'm sure.
Everybody sing it out.
As long as I'm breathing, I have a reason.
word for you, it never returns to him void. It does exactly what it's meant to do. So with the faith in this room, I want you to lift up your hands as a sign of surrender and tell Jesus, I'm here. Do something new in my life as I reset. I call on you, Jesus. You are in this place and you've never failed. Thank you, Jesus. You've never failed. You are faithful. You are awesome. You are awesome. Hallelujah.
I just wanna speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Every voice calling on Jesus.
I just wanna speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break.
Declaring
there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus.
Call him now. all. Master, you deserve our worship. You deserve our adoration. You deserve all our praise, oh God. We exalt you this morning, giving you thanks and adoration for all the things that you have done. Lord, you have been good. You have been faithful. You have been true to your word. You are our Jehovah Jireh. Lord, you have provided for us. Oh God, our Ebenezer, this far you have brought us. Lord, many of us didn't even think we would come this far, but for your grace, oh God Almighty. So we thank you this morning. We lift up our voices in adoration. You are a good God. You are a good Father. You are a good Master. Father, we are honored and privileged to be called your daughters. We are honored and privileged to be called your children. We are honored and privileged to be a part of this mighty army, serving a God that never fails us. We thank you for who you are. Lord, we thank you for bringing us to this day. Jesus, we have prepared. Lord, we have planned. We have thought about this gathering. And all we can say right now is, look what the Lord has done. It is beautiful in our eyes. Master, we thank you. Lord, we exalt you. We give you thanks. We give you adoration. You who never counts our sins on us, but as far as the east is from the west, so far have you taken our sins, our shame, our guilt from us, oh God. And you welcome us with open hands and ask for your embrace, oh God. As we ask for your embrace, Lord, you take us in. You deserve the glory, oh God. You deserve the honor, mighty God. You deserve the adoration, oh God. So we lift you high. Come on, ladies, lift up the name of Jesus. Thank him in your own words. He has been true. He has been faithful. Let every man be a liar but our God. Let every man be a cheat but our God. He is a good God. It doesn't matter what you have experienced. He's true to himself. Master, we are grateful. Lift him up and adore him. Give him the adoration and the praise that he deserves. Give him the honor that King Jesus deserves. Oh, you are worthy, oh God. You have been good. You have been kind. You have been loving. Thank you for who you are. I just want us to take a moment of silence in his presence. Think about his goodness. Only you know how far the Lord has drawn you. Only you understand the accidents he saved you from. Those border accidents that were near misses. Think about his goodness in your life and your families, your children, your husband, your workplace. Heavenly Father, we are grateful. Oh God, you have been good. You whose faithfulness is from everlasting to everlasting, how could we ever repay you for your kindness toward us? Lord, if it hadn't been for you, the enemy would have swallowed us. But praise be to our Father, who causes us to triumph. Lord, if it hadn't been for you, sickness and disease would have swallowed us. But we have seen you as Rapha in our lives. Master, praise be to your name. Lord, if it hadn't been for you, lack would have consumed us. But you have been Jireh to us. Praise be to your name, O God Almighty. O God, amidst the chaos, you have given us shalom. Lord, we are grateful. Father, even when we have gone through the waters, you didn't save us from them, but you were faithful to carry us through the storms, and we came out the other side. Oh God, you have been faithful. Who are we to be privileged to be called daughters of the Most High King? Lord, we are grateful. So we come before you this morning just to say thank you. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for mercy. Thank you for grace. Thank you for kindness. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for refreshment. Lord, thank you for reviving our souls. We appreciate you. We are forever grateful. We are forever thankful. And Lord, we want to say, we want to give the very best of us to serve you and to live for you. Of course, we can't do this on our own. Holy Spirit, we ask that you will help us to live for you, to live for the Father, to live for Jesus, and bring him glory. That when all is said and done, Master, we will stand before you and hear you say, well done, good and faithful servant. So we thank you, we bless you, and we honor you. And all this we pray in the name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus. Come on, give him a hand clap of praise. Thank you, Lord.
Amen and amen. You may be seated. Thank you, Jackie, for leading us in prayer. Then as we take our seats, there's a scripture that's on my heart even as we are worshiping. Revelation chapter 4, verse 11 says this. You are worthy, our Lord and God, to receive all glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being. So when we sing, you are worthy of it all, indeed he is worthy of it all. So I want us to go ahead and give God a hand of praise and say, you alone are worthy of our worship, Lord, because only he is worthy of praise. Only he is worthy of worship. Only he is worthy of honor and glory and power forever and ever. Amen. 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 Welcome, welcome once again. Turn to your sister, welcome them to the house of the Lord. Welcome them to this beautiful sisterhood big gathering 2024. Great. Now, when we started, the house was almost full. I must say now the house is overflowing. So, ladies, I know that we are coming from all different walks and places, and we are still streaming in. So we just want to take note of everyone who is here. Yes? Now, every time we gather like this, Jackie, we have people who are coming in this house for the very first time. If it's your very first time to worship with us at Watoto, not Watoto Church, but at Watoto, you are so special to us today. You're our guest, and we want to take note of you. If you're in here, would you just stretch your hand up? Just raise it up high. It's your first time. Yes, yes, I see hands everywhere. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Watoto Church. We are so happy to have you on a special day like this. Oh, yes. Welcome, neighbors. Feel, help the guests feel welcome this morning. You are at Watoto Church, Bweyogerere, and we are so privilege to have you this morning. Right now, one of our host ushers is reaching out to you with a card. And that card has a message from our team leader, Pastors Julius and Vanita. It also has a tear-off section. Kindly go ahead and fill in the information on the tear-off. We are not trying to register you as a member of the church. We are taking note of your visit. And if you have a minute, that very usher will be happy to talk to you more about who we are and what we do as a church. Now, after filling in that information, just go ahead and hand it back to the usher. We will get in touch with you and see how we can tell you more about who we are. If you're coming from another church, please send them our love and greetings. Tell them to keep loving Jesus. We love Jesus at Watoto Church. If you're looking for a church to belong, you're from the neighborhood, we are more than happy to have you here. Or you could be from a distant land. Don't worry, if you look at that card, it has all the celebration points that meet in different angles at Watoto. So you could find that there's one right where you stay. We will be more than happy to have you on a Sunday. Once again, Watoto Church family, sisters, let's give it up for all our first-time visitors. Yes, and I'm sure there are those online. We haven't forgotten you now. Right now, there's a link that's coming up. Click that link and give us information about you, and we will be happy to connect with you if you're online. You are absolutely welcome, and we're happy to have you this day.
Amen.
Yes, Jackie.
Now that you have welcomed the first-time visitors, those that are not from Watoto Church, I think we need to welcome the Watoto Church.
I agree with you.
But as we talk about Watoto Church visitors, many of you are visitors, especially you, Maria. This is your first time in this building, right or wrong? Ladies,
right.
Let's give Maria a welcome. First time visitor in this building.
Thank you, thank you.
And we many know of that us. Some of you are out there and you used to hear about Watoto Weyo Gerere.
Yes.
You'd see the building on the TV in your celebration point. This is us.
Yes.
You have arrived in Wales.
I must say it looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. Now let's see who is in the house.
Yes.
Yes? You never know, as the guests might be more than you guys today. Okay, are we ready for this? Yes? When you hear your campus, make the loudest noise. Yes? Are we ready for this?
Yeah.
Do we have Watoto Church Chengera by any chance? We have them.
Very good. What about Watoto Church Nansana?
Wow. Beautiful. Do we have Watoto Church Bugolobi?
Watoto Church Kansanga?
Do we have Watoto Church Downtown?
What about Watoto Church in Tinda?
Watoto Church in Tinda, behave, behave, okay?
Yeah.
Do we have Watoto Church Luboa?
Whoa! What other Watoto Church campuses do we have? Which one? Hey! Sorry! Watoto Church Entebbe.
By here, they are nearer the outside countries because they are always
exactly.
Yes. Okay. Do we have, now this, I love these women. Do we have Watoto Church Bira? Subi? Laminadera? Laminadera, what are you doing here? Watoto Church Guru has the gathering. Laminadera, but we love you.
But we might have people from that place.
Yes.
The diaspora. Mm-hmm. What about Watoto Church Jinja?
We have some representatives.
Jinja is represented
yes.
too.
And Bara might be represented too.
You never know.
They might be following Pastor Graham and Shida. They
it's
came to visit
possible.
To see that
why
they are fine.
You
did you come, Bara? Hey, they said they are aware that there is a gathering. Okay, good.
Oh, wow.
Who have we forgotten?
Not yet. Skip, wait.
That's it, I think.
Online.
Send
emojis
right now.
Everyone.
Hats, online. Just
yeah,
send. And tell us where
family.
You you're tuning in from.
Now, we may have people that you don't necessarily come to Watoto Church, but you have visited from other churches. Do we have some like that? Other churches that have come to attend? Very good. You are very, very welcome.
Yes.
We welcome you here. Now, lastly, you know what I mean.
Okay.
And others are serving outside.
We are thankful that they are serving, because I don't know if we can contain this noise. So those who are serving, thank you very much. Please stay at your post. We appreciate. Thank you so much for hosting us. We are going to behave while we are here. But we, Boyos, thank you for coming out in big numbers, and thank you for hosting us today. Now, as I invite Pastor Martha to come, make her way to the front. Ladies, we have a tent set out, and later on, as we start to get out, please go and interact. All those tents have ladies from Watoto Church who have set out things for you to support a sister, and I hope you did come with what we mentioned earlier, yes, in the announcement. So during the break, and when you're hungry, please don't hesitate to go grab something to eat. There is plenty of things for you to eat. We won't run out. I just wanted to let you know that refreshments and eats are out there as and when you need them on sale. Over to you, Martha.
Thank you very much. Come on, let's appreciate the Oguals, Jackie and Maria. Thank you very much for welcoming us and making us feel at home. Well, my name is Martha Mwesije, and together with my husband, Pastor Edward Mwesije, it's such an honor to serve right here at Watoto Church as the pastoral team leaders. Happy Women's Day, ladies. From where I'm standing, you look absolutely beautiful. If no one has told you yet, at least I have. Well, as the Watoto Church family, we celebrate Christ and? Care for community. We believe that God has given us a big vision to reach the lost, to disciple the lonely, to love the least. And in sharing the love of Christ, we will indeed see healing and transformation in our communities, in our cities, and in our nation. I'm going to invite a very special lady up here on stage, Belinda Katende, a sister, to tell us more. But as she comes, just stand with me, Matthew chapter 25. Just, you know, something that will happen on Judgment Day and something that we're involved in as community care. I'm reading from 34 to 36, that then the king will say to those on his right, "Come you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. I needed clothes and you clothed me. I was sick, you looked after me. I was in prison, you came to visit me." So Belinda, tell us, what is Power FM during this Easter season, and how can these beautiful ladies be involved?
Thank you, Martha. Good morning, ladies. What a celebration of color. Clap for yourselves. You look amazing. And from my vantage point, you know, they look so beautiful today. You guys are wearing these colors with so much grace. Well, my name is Belinda Katende, and I'm privileged to lead the team at Power FM 104.1, All About Love. Any Power FM Love family members here? We're happy to see you today. Well, it's Easter. Easter is just around the corner. And at Power FM, that means we have a heart for the people in prison around the Easter season. And it's the 14th year of Easter in prison. Can you imagine that? We've been doing this with your help for 14 years now. And we are ready to go back into those prisons and make a difference. Now, last year, we went to Mbarara Women's Prison, and that was a prison that hosts about 200 inmates. And we wanted to show them that God's daughters are cherished. Now, with your support and your love and your contributions, we took them some basic necessities. We took them, we went with a pastor, we had a deliverance session. We witnessed 28 women giving their lives to Christ. Now, that was awesome. And you know what the icing on the cake was? It spilled over next door to the men's prison. There's a men's prison just next door, and they had all the amazing things going on, and the OC invited us in to say hi to him, and we were able to take some of the stuff that we had and bless them as well. And so that was Mbarara. This year, guess where we are going? Jinja, that's right. We're headed to Jinja. And the prison is called Chirinya Prison Complex. It is a three-part prison. It has Jinja Main, Jinja Remand, and Jinja Women's Prison. Jinja Main has about 2,000 inmates, Jinja Remand, 1,200. And Jinja Women has 100 women and 8 babies that were born in the prison. And so we want you ladies with your big hearts to partner with us as we go into the prison this Easter season. We just want you to contribute 40,000 shillings towards the cause, or to bring items in kind. We are taking sanitary towels, we're taking toilet paper, we're taking bars of soap as well, and scholastic materials for the student inmates, because there are so many who are studying and kind of developing themselves inside the prison. And so you can contribute by sending mobile money, 0753 104 104 or 0776 106 104. Or you can come over to the Power FM offices along Buganda Road, Watoto Church downtown, just opposite Senana building, and bring your items in kind, bring your money. We will be so happy to have you partnering with us. And in advance, I'd like to say God bless you for your generosity. Thank you so much for always doing this with us. Yes. Have a wonderful time.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Belinda. And Belinda, just to let you know, that as the leadership of Sisterhood and the team organizing this year's big event, we will give you a portion of the past that the ladies have brought so that you can go and be a blessing to the women in prison. Thank you very much. And ladies, thank you so much for your generosity. In case you brought your pads and you're still with them, there will be big baskets as you get out, but already we are blessed by your generosity. And in case you are wondering, why? I mean, what is Keep a Girl in School? I have a very beautiful lady called Brenda coming to share her testimony so that indeed you can see the impact of what a sanitary pad can do. Brenda, you're very welcome. Happy Women's Day.
Happy Women's Day too.
The ladies are wondering, why are you looking so smart in a uniform, and what is your story?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Brenda.
Happy Women's Day.
Happy Women's Day.
My name is Sapio Brenda Prosi, and I am really so delighted to stand in front of you here today to share my story with you. And here it goes. My parents separated when I was in primary 7, and I didn't go back to get my result, despite the fact that I got a first grade with 11 aggregates, because the school fees was not cleared. After that, I was left to stay with my stepmother, living with no parent as my father was jailed in prison. I continued to stay with my stepmother, but due to the nymphomania that my stepmom had, she got married to another man, leaving me in the house with 3 young siblings for me to take care of them. Life became so hard unto me, living as a child of 12 years, as a child aiding a family. After that, I continued to look after my young siblings. But due to much intention that I had for studies and the love that I had for my young siblings, I started to do some odd casual jobs like working in people's farm, working as a housemaid in order for me to buy food and put on table for my siblings. Life really became so hard unto me. I would go back to school. During lunchtime and break time, I had to come back and do some chores, which I would complete in the evening so that I can be paid money for the day. Life really became so hard. One day I was in class. I had no pad, but my menstruation started. I used to pluck papers from my book in order for me to pad myself. I had no sanitary towels. I had nothing in the house to eat. But all those things were me to provide everything and take care of the young siblings. Life really became so hard unto me. Even my relatives looked at me as a trash to be dumped. They abused me. They mistreated me the way they wanted. One day I decided to commit a suicide because I could not withstand the situation anymore. But I sat down and looked down onto myself. I didn't commit the suicide, but I just walked away. When I was walking, I met a woman, and she asked me where I was going. And then I told her everything about me. And she took me to her home to stay with her 12 children. And afterward, she continued to do more research about me. And she found out that I am the daughter to her brother. And right now, she is taking care of me. Her and her husband, they are all both peasant farmers, and they are now old. They are also struggling to survive and take care of a big family. When the pale result came back, because I resisted, but due to the situation that I was going through, I dropped. And I got 16 aggregate. But the Lord was still too gracious to me. In the school that I was studying, no one could get like a second grade. They would get like third grade or fourth grade. But I stood out that year. And then on one of the outreaches, my teachers identified me as the best performer. And I was brought to Watoto to be part of the Kagis fan. And right now, as I talk, I am in Senior 3 at Hope Senior School Naturebe, working so hard to ensure that my dream as to become a neurosurgeon doctor is true. So I want to encourage everyone who is here. Watoto has really impacted me. They granted me free education. They granted me free scholastic materials. They granted me pads. and parts has really kept me clean because I was about to drop out of school because of the parts. I used to smell so bad, but now I am safe and I am free. I have kept myself clean all the time because of the parts that Watoto has provided me. So I want to encourage everyone who is here, mostly the girls, if you know that you have gone through the same situation as me, or you're still going through, just count yourself right now that you are not a failure, but you are something in life. You can accomplish something that no one in this world has ever accomplished. And the word of God also tells us in the book of Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3 that whoever calls unto me, I will answer. I will tell you wonders and marvelous things that you know nothing about. And his word continues to tell us in the book of Isaiah that I will make you be known in all the world.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you.
Not only in your family, not only in your clan, but you will be known in the whole world.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just pray to God. Do everything right. Be righteous. Mm. The Lord is so faithful. With all this, I beg to stop here. And I say, may God bless Watoto. May God bless Watoto abundantly.
Wonderful. Thank you,
Thank
Brenda.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Brenda. No, apart from giving me a hug, you have to take it. Thank you for sharing your story with us. I guess I don't have to say anymore. You've heard it from her. Brenda is just one of tens of thousands of girls that whose lives God is transforming through the generosity of people like you and I towards the Keep a Girl in School program. And today, 78 schools that we are partnering with here in Kampala, Gulu, and in Juba, South Sudan. Okay? So you can be a part of it. Today, you brought a pack. You could decide to actually partner with KAGIS on a long-term basis, on a monthly basis, when you sign up to support Watoto Neighborhood. You can do that as an individual. You can do that as CSR in an organization. I remember last year we had an organization here, a business. Every month they committed to donating 16 boxes of sanitary towels so that we could go and change the lives of the girls who are needed, who needed them and were vulnerable. So you could do that as well. And there's a table on my right as you go at a sponsorship table. In case you need more information, you can go there. But in case you came and you did not have sanitary pads, you can also donate on a financial basis. Okay, ladies? Now, a very special lady that I want to introduce to you today. We do have, not only do we get support for KAGIS here in Uganda, but across all our 11 country offices, we have people that say we believe in what God is doing through Watoto to transform the lives of these little girls, and we will come alongside you. How many of us have heard of Priscilla Shira? Watched her movies, read her books, listened to her podcast, maybe you know her YouTube channels. Well, Priscilla Shira partnered with KAGIS a couple of years ago through, you know, when they hosted Aunt Marilyn Skinner, and they raised about $500,000 US dollars. Isn't that amazing? And with that partnership, we were able to actually start KAGIS in Juba, South Sudan. Today, we have a lady from Going Beyond Ministries, Shannon Cook. Shannon, maybe just stand up a bit so the ladies can. So Shannon, I hope you take this as appreciation from us here at Watoto and KAGIS that we are grateful for your partnership. And thank you for choosing to celebrate Women's Day with us here today. So thank you very much. So that is our section on community care. I'm going to invite beautiful Violet to tell us about generosity, which is also another core value of ours here at Watoto. Please, make her feel welcome as she takes us into the next session. Over to you, Violet.
Good morning, something small that I wrote in my journal. God's grace towards us is abundant, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Excessively so. If we would simply stop and take stock of our blessing, we would quickly see how truly overwhelming the Lord's generosity towards us is. Can anybody testify to that? Absolutely. Therefore, giving is an expression of joy. It's an expression of gratitude for the bounty of God's goodness. I'm reminded of the gift of the lady who demonstrated her indebtedness to Jesus when she anointed his feet with a jar of costly ointment. She loved much, Jesus said, because she had been forgiven much. I don't know what your journey has been like with God. I don't know what he has healed you from. I don't know what he has delivered you from. But one thing I am confident about is that when Jesus steps in the room, it does not remain the same. The chains he has broken, the diseases he has healed, the prayers that he has answered, there are so many. You cannot count them. And so this is the moment where we say, Jesus, thank you. We give cheerfully, we give sacrificially, because he gave much more and he's still giving. And so, ladies, it is now our time to give. And as we give in the red bags, that's where we put our tithes and our offerings. And in the blue bags, that's where we put our Build God's House Fund. We also are still giving our Miracle Missions offering. So feel free to ask the ushers to give you that little envelope and then drop it in the bag as it goes around. And for the ladies online, we have not forgotten you. We have electronic giving. We are going to be showing the video online. If you could kindly turn your eyes to the screen, you can watch how to give electronically. Thank you.
Please take a moment to explore the various giving options available on our website, wototochurch.com/giving. You can conveniently give through the website or by scanning the QR code displayed on your screen. For those who prefer mobile money, we have provided specific instructions and codes for various carriers. If you wish to give securely through Visa or MasterCard, debit or credit cards, that option is also available. You can also find details about other giving methods, such as checks, bank transfers, or agent banking, on the same page. For those attending our 16 celebration points, we have secure gift boxes available for easy envelope drop-offs, providing a convenient giving solution. If you're watching from Juba, South Sudan, we have tailored giving options, including bank transfer, checks, agent banking, MTN MomoPay, and MGurush. Thank you, family, for your faithfulness in contributing to the growth of God's kingdom.
Pleasure than pain. But eventually the sinful virus became inflamed. I could feel the rush of the disease growing until it could no longer be tamed. You ask me why would I allow sin to have this much control? Why would I give up my freedom? Because that was never my goal. So I sit here perplexed and my spirit is vexed. I begin to feel desperation because my life was a mess. Praying, God, if you're real, you gotta help me because I can't see through. My vision is blinded and I can't see you. Then I begin to go back and forth in my mind. Do I give God my time or do I let sin's destruction incline? There was warfare happening in the depths of my soul. The devil wanted me to stay, but I really wanted to go. So in that moment, I just dropped to my knees. In that moment, I screamed, God, help me, please. I am desperate. I am desperate, but yet I can't even decide. I am desperate, God, and you I need to hide. Because the devil is chasing after me full force. I am exhausted and I can't maintain this course. Out of my desperation, God began to speak. He said, I've always loved you. I was just waiting on you to seek. But God, I know I'm hurting, but I'm not ready to let go. God said, there's a sacrifice you must give. Relinquish control. Everything you need, I'll be. Everything you need, I'll be. This is what God began to minister to me. Everything you need, I'll be. I'll cover the hole in your soul, but you must be willing to be broken in order to be made whole. So draw nigh to me and your heart I'll remold. See, the victory is yours because the price I already paid. No, you don't deserve it, but by my grace you are saved. The path to freedom is only paved one way. The choice is yours, so choose ye this day.
Water.
Yes, let's give it up for them one more time.
Martha.
Now, if you know you can't even do that dance, clap even louder. Wow, thank you so much. The message was quite clear. What's our theme for the day? Some people here know it. Let me hear it. What's our theme for today?
Hit reset.
Hit reset. Now, I thought we were having fun earlier, but now this is the real deal. This is a time you can't afford to go look for something to eat. If you're hungry, stay. You're about to eat the real food. So stay. If you've used the bathroom and wanted to use again, you stay. The Lord is going to sustain you because you can't afford to miss the next moment. I just want you to get rid of all distraction, and I'm about to invite a friend. The lady I'm about to invite is so sweet. When you get to know her, you realize you're like, oh, you're sweet. She's a sister. She's a... Let me not say that one. I might be fired from the stage. But she can dance. Last time I said she can't dance, then we realized she can actually dance. She doesn't have two left feet. But she's small and short. Make no mistake, she's not small at heart. She's a giant. She loves the Lord. She inspires me to love the Lord and to pray and to seek God. No wonder she's telling us to hit reset today, because everything she does reflects the one that she serves. And today, she nailed monochrome. Ladies, please welcome with me our mama, our sister. Vanita Rotlonyo.
Thank you, Maria. Maria, I love you too. And you're forgiven. You just said I can dance, so I forgive you. Happy Women's Day, ladies. It is such a joy to be here in the room with each one of you. And I'm reminded of this song we sing, with all of the faith in the room. You know, can you imagine what the Lord can do? The Lord will never, ever let his daughters gather together in his name and he doesn't show up. So he's in the room and he's going to do some amazing things for you and I on this special Women's Day. So again, happy Women's Day, ladies. Now, the God we serve is a multi-generational God. His faithfulness endures through generations. He's been faithful to us as Watoto for the past 40 years. You know, Watoto did not start with Julius and I. It started with our founders, Pastors Gary and Marilyn. Watoto's sisterhood did not start with Manita. It started with our founder, Marilyn Skinner. And today she's in the house. And I want us to welcome her as she comes to say hi to us.
I love you, every one of you. You know, when sisters get together, Jesus smiles. Do you believe that? And not only does he smile, but he blesses. Because there's no one that empowered women more than Jesus Christ. That tells me that he loves women and we have a special place in his heart. You know, the girls that sang that last song, oh, wasn't that beautiful? I was reminded of the day my name was written down in the book of glory. Do you remember the name, your name was put in glory? Mine was 62 years ago. That's a long time. And you may be here today and your name's not yet written in the book of glory. It can be. You don't have to leave this place the way you came. You know, I've been contemplating life the older I get. And life is full of seasons. Seasons come, seasons go. Seasons are good, seasons are bad. There's seasons when you can feel that you really are nothing. But what did our sisters tell us? I am, says who you are. And you know, this week as I've been contemplating life, I've realized that even though you may feel weak, even though we may feel weak, did you know that Jesus doesn't ask for your strength? Do you know why? Because he has more than enough power in himself. He doesn't need your strength. Do you know what he asks for? Your weakness, because he has none of that in himself. And this is the amazing thing. This is what I've learned since my name was written down in glory. That if we give our weakness to Jesus, he uses it as an instrument in his mighty hand. So you may have come this afternoon, this morning, and you may feel like you are nothing. Won't you give your nothingness to Jesus? And let him take his strength and use it as an instrument in his hand. Now, are you ready for the word of God? You're not convincing me. Are you ready for the word of God? Open your heart. Open your mind. Open your spirit. And I can guarantee you, you will not leave this place the way you came. Jesus, anoint our leader, Vernita, as she brings your word. Holy Spirit, give her clarity of thought, clarity of words, and may your words pierce every heart that is here and transform in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
And I can still walk downstairs in heels. But don't ask me to dance because too small.
Thank you, Mom. I honor you and I thank God for you. And Jackie, where's Jackie? Jackie is somewhere sorting out something. Jackie, I just want to say thank you for hosting us so beautifully. Plus everyone who calls Boyogerere home, thank you for hosting us. Already we're having a marvelous time. Now I have to say you look really good in your monochrome. And you know, just thinking about how women have taken the time to put their outfits together, I'm reminded of Proverbs 31:30. And this is what it says. Charm is deceptive, beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Today, I pray that we will go beyond the monochrome. We will look beyond the beauty and we will fix our eyes on Jesus. Lord, I thank you because you're in this place. Now arrest every thought, every heart, and fill this room with your presence and do what only you can do in and through us, in Jesus' name. Beautiful as ladies are, you have to agree we are beautiful, right? And the Lord really loves us. We are his special daughters. We are precious to him. Even with all that, life throws challenges at us from time to time. And when those challenges come our way, they can throw us off course and we end up compromising and making some choices that are not necessarily that great. And this reminds me of the scripture in Jeremiah 6:16. And this is what the Lord says. Stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient paths. Ask where the good way is and walk in it. And you will find rest for your souls. When I talk about compromise and making poor choices in life, that's the equivalent of going off the course that the Lord has marked out for us. And that grieves his heart. And today he's saying, hey, my daughter, it's time to hit reset. It's time to get back on the ancient path that I marked out for you so that you will find rest for your souls. Amen? So I want us to dive into what that means today. What does hit reset mean for you and I as a child of God? And it can be many different things, as many as the people in this room. But we don't have time to get into all of it. So I picked just a few that I think are really critical for each one of us as a child of God to hit reset and get back to the ancient path that the Lord marks out for us. So let's dive in. The first area that I think we need to hit reset and is very critical today is in the area of mental health. So we need to hit reset mentally. And when you think about life, I think about Brenda, who just shared her testimony and how her dad was put in jail and she had nowhere to go. She had to take care of her siblings. She had no food. And she began to think suicidal thoughts. That's a lie from the enemy when he starts to tell you life is over. There's no more point. And I know there's many in this room who can identify with Brenda one way or another. Ladies who have considered taking their own lives because there's no hope. Oh, I think of that girl who's at the university. She just graduated and she aced it. She finished with flying colors and she had such great hopes and great dreams for her life. And she knew the future was bright. But 3 years down the road, she still has no job and she's feeling like a failure. She's feeling defeated and she's giving up on her dreams and she's quitting. And she's wondering why the wicked girls who are at the university with her are succeeding. And it's beginning to look attractive on the other side. Oh, I think of this lady. You might even be here and you've waited on the Lord. You've waited and waited and waited. And your desire has always been to get married and have children. And all your friends have gotten married, their kids are growing up, and you're discouraged because it hasn't happened for you. And you decide to quit on yourself because that was your dream. And you no longer care how you dress, you don't care what you eat, you don't care if your house looks good or bad, you just don't care because your focus was wanting to get married and it's not happening. Oh, I think of this precious wife who's saying to herself, I did everything I could, but the man walked away and left me and my kids. And I'm wondering how I'll survive without him. It can be any shape or form of disappointments that hit you. And the truth is they hit all of us. But don't give up. Because even when it happens, it's not the end. And the Lord is saying us today, oh child of mine, it's time to hit reset. You're not defeated. It is not over unless I say so. I have a great plan for you. Fix your eyes on me. Do not fix your eyes on the situations because all things are possible with God. And the enemy will lie to you and whisper. After all, he's the father of lies, isn't he? But today, as we hit reset mentally, the Lord is saying, listen to the truth of God's word. Listen to his truth. Let it be life to you and say no to the lies of the enemy. And it's a fight. You may not realize it, but it's a fight. It's a fight for your future. It's a fight for your generations. And this is how the book of 2 Corinthians in chapter 10 puts it. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, They have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension, that's the lies of the enemy, that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. And we take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. So what is that thought that's lingering? Is it the thought that it's over for me? I'm defeated. I need to take my life. I am worthless. Whatever it is, if it doesn't align with the truth of God's word, let's take it captive to the obedience of God by subjecting it to the truth of God's word. So how do we do that practically? You delve into the word of God. That's how you renew your mind, by feeding on the word of God. So let's feed on the word of God. Surround yourself with godly counsel that will speak life into you, and stay away from anything that projects the lies of the enemy. The second area where we need to hit reset is emotionally. Hit reset emotionally. Now, when all the disappointments we've talked about happen, all sorts of feelings come up. You know, there's hatred, bitterness, anger, rejection, resentfulness, unforgiveness, jealousy, name it. There are many that come up. And when they come up, the question is, what do you do about them? Do you feed on them? Anger has come in. Do you act in anger? Or do you turn away from it and subject it to the word of God and do what the Lord wants you to do? So even as we hit reset, it's important for us to be mindful of how we handle emotional issues. And when you have emotional wounds from all these things we've talked about, you're in such a vulnerable place. And listen, when you're in a vulnerable place, the Bible says that Satan, the enemy, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for who to devour. And when we have emotional wounds and we're down and they're undealt with, we're in a weak, vulnerable state, and he's more likely to attack us. So it's very important that we deal with these emotional wounds and do not give the devil a foothold in our lives. And specifically, I want to talk about unforgiveness and bitterness. And this is what the Bible says about unforgiveness in Mark 11:25. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins. Now, I've heard it said, unforgiveness is like drinking poison and hoping the other person will die, the one who has wronged you. Unforgiveness is poison to your soul. It will kill you, not the other person. So it's important that we deal with that unforgiveness and get it out of the way in our lives. Because think about it, when you carry unforgiveness, the Lord will not forgive you. Because he says, go forgive, then I'll forgive you. So when you carry unforgiveness, it's like deciding, oh, I'm not living under the cover of God. I am going to carry my sins. I'm going to move with my baggage. And you're defenseless. You're open. You're a wide open target to the enemy to attack. All because you choose to carry unforgiveness. All because you choose to hold on to offense instead of letting it go and enjoying the sweet fellowship of the Lord. So today, as we hit reset, you might be here and you feel like, I have legitimate reasons for not forgiving her. She stole my husband. I mean, that's a terrible thing, isn't it? Or she's bewitched me. You know, we do all sorts of wicked things in this world, but none of it is worth you drinking poison, is it? So today, let's make a conscious decision to forgive whoever it is, so that the Lord can forgive us as well. It is for your good that you forgive. And directly, closely related with unforgiveness is bitterness. Now, when you carry anger and all those negative feelings, they poison your soul. And bitterness comes up in your soul. Like the word bitterness says, it's bitter. So your soul is bitter. And you find when you're bitter, you're very unpleasant, you're critical, you're quarrelsome. No one wants to be around you because you're bitter. There is nothing good to come out of you. And it's been said that the single most common reason that people don't get healed is because of carrying unforgiveness and bitterness. And bitterness will literally open your life up to sickness and disease. I think we've had it said. So it's just not worth it to carry bitterness. And this is what Ephesians 4:31 says. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling, and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ, God forgave you. Let's make a conscious decision to hit reset in the emotional area so that we are free to walk with the Lord with our hearts pure and clean, not weighted down by baggage. Amen? The next area where I want to dwell a little bit more, we need to hit reset in the area of purity. Now, purity is such a big thing. And we'll talk about different areas of purity. There's sexual purity for a start. And again, I'll go back to what the Bible says. Do you not know that your bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You're not your own. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your bodies. Living a life of purity means walking in holiness before the Lord. For us to live a life of purity, first of all, it starts with our bodies. Because when we indulge in sexual sin, it soils our bodies, right? And yet, I bring sexual sin up because the issue of the attack on sexual purity today is crazy. It's crazy. And I bring it up because it's not just out there. It's here in the church. You know, just recently when we were discussing and I was putting together this message, I had some things I'd never even imagined. The level of sexual deviance, there's a lot of creativity to it every single day. You know, regardless of where you are, you know, at the university, there's sex for marks. In the workplace, there's sex for promotion. There's virginity-breaking parties where today people are throwing parties so that you can break your virginity. Can I just tell you that if anyone is celebrating you for breaking your virginity, it's because they already lost theirs and they are regretting it and they are being malicious, they are being used of the devil to pull you down. It's precious and the Lord meant for you to keep it until you're married. The lies the devil will tell us is it's so old-fashioned to be a virgin. It is not. It is the coolest thing ever to be single and a virgin. So if you're here today and you're a virgin and you're single, if you're married, we have counseling after, you know. But if you're single and you're a virgin, I applaud you. I cheer you on. Keep going, sister. Hold on. Remain faithful. Remain pure. But the list goes on. There's, I have them here. There's what they call the side chick movement. Well, married men have side chicks, and these side chicks get into a movement to support one another, to tell each other how to handle their married men. and their issues. And so they tell you, oh no, that married man of yours, this is what mine gives you. He needs to give you that. He should give you a better house. This is how you handle the wife. This, it's right here in church, just so you know. Listen, today we need to hit reset. Before the Lord brings a fiery chiboko and deals with us, right? We need to hit reset today. There's homosexuality and lesbianism for money. Not because you have the feelings, but because it's lucrative business. So you engage in it. There's watch parties for porn. You know, we do watch parties for the service online. There's, you know, the devil texts it and says, come do watch parties for porn. Now, all these things we engage in, the devil will lie to you and say, oh, sex is just the body. It's just the body. Nothing, you know, so if you use protection, there's no sickness. You're covered. Just have fun. Can I just tell you that that is a lie from the pit of hell? Because the Lord who instituted the marriage, that the institution of marriage, ordained that sex should be enjoyed between the holy covenant of marriage, between one man and one woman. And he says in Genesis that when the two get together, the two become one flesh. One flesh actually means one soul. So when you indulge in sex outside of marriage, you know what happens? You're one soul, you create soul ties with John, you go have it with Timothy, you create soul ties with Timothy, you go have it with Moses, you create soul ties with Moses. Then if you involve lesbians, you go and create soul ties with Jane. You know, then you find that you're tied in the spirit to all these people. And because you're tied outside the sacred covenant of God, do you know who's presiding over your covenant? It's a demonic covenant. So you're involved in all these demonic soul ties. And you know what happens? Because you're one, if Moses has demons tormenting him, those demons have legal access to you and begin to torment you. If Peter also has another caliber of demons, they also begin to torment you. If Jen has another category of demons, do you see the cocktail of mess you're indulging in? Just by saying sex is just physical, I'm just having fun, it is the cool thing today. Cool, but those demons know nothing like cool. They will torment you. And it's just not worth it, child of God. It is not worth it. It's not cool. Whenever we deviate from God's plan for sexuality, we've opened the door to demonic oppression in our lives. Do you hear me, sister? You might be here today and you're indulging in sexual sin. And you have convinced yourself it's okay. After all, I love the Lord. When I'm done, I repent. It's not okay. It is not okay. Hear me today. It is time to hit reset and stop. Say no to sexual sin. Put a stop to it. And then turn away and repent and say, oh Lord, forgive me. And because there's soul ties that are created, break those soul ties. Break those soul ties in the name of Jesus. If you have no idea how to do that, at the end of this sisterhood event today, we have lots of counselors who are waiting to walk with you. So please do not go away from here tied down with such things. Amen? Let's hit reset in the area of sexuality. Another one is purity of eyes and ears. Now, these eyes and ears are the gate to the soul. A lot of things come into the soul based on what we watch and what we hear. I just talked about watch parties for porn. Imagine indulging in that. Before I go to that, let me, you know, that's a bit heavy. But, you know, when you, for instance, when you watch violent movies and all these things that do not speak of the Lord, whatever it is projected on your life. And, you know, when I was preparing this, I just remembered when my kids were little and they used to love watching PJ Masks. That was a kid's program on TV. And they loved watching Angry Birds. They would watch Angry Birds at a friend's place. And PJ Masks, because in the night we save the day. You know, there's a lot of violence. The good kids are fighting with the bad guys. There's anger. There's sabotage. There's all these things that are violent. And suddenly I realized my kids, who are about 7 or even younger, started to be angry and violent at home. And it was their dad who noticed it first and said, it's that PJ Masks because it has violence. And we realized that innocently, without knowing it, we had opened a door. We had opened a door to the enemy just by allowing the kids to watch PJ Masks and Angry Birds. And so the spirit of anger and violence was beginning to influence their actions. Now let's take it further again to the area of pornography. I say this because pornography is so destructive. And it is becoming such a big thing today because, I mean, internet is so readily available and you can consume it any day you want and just at the click of your phone. Now, I'm reminded of a story of a young man who went to a counselor and he told the pastor, Pastor, I know with all my heart I am not gay. I have no intention of ever being with a man. I have no intention of ever acting on gay feelings, but I am struggling with gay feelings. I am attracted to men. And so as the pastor talked to him and dug in, you know, he asked him, have you ever watched pornography? And he said, yes. And he asked him, have you watched gay porn? And he said, yes. And he said, right there is your challenge. Because you see, you're from Priscilla Shire. When we do a movie like War Room, there's a lot of spiritual preparation that goes into it. Because it's meant to draw you closer to God. There's prayer, there's fasting, there's reading the word, there's all these things, interceding before the Lord to do the movie right so that it can hit the hearts of men and transform them to be more like Jesus. In the same way, when the people who craft these wicked movies come together, they have an agenda. And I promise you, it's not to draw you closer to God. Because their sponsor is not God. It is the devil himself. So their agenda is to draw you as deep as possible into the demonic, into wicked things. So you come innocently, naively, foolishly, and you watch this wicked, filthy content. There's a demon behind it. And so the pastor told this man, there was a demon of homosexuality, you know? Because there are demons of lust. We are talking demons, but it is very real, you know? We can want to pretend, oh no, let's leave this, but it is the reality that he's around looking for who to devour. And I don't want any of you sisters to be a victim. So let's be knowledgeable, let's be equipped so that we can do what we need to do to hit reset. So anyway, what I'm trying to say is when we indulge in this wicked, filthy content, there's a spirit behind it and we open the door to an attack from it. So whenever you watch those violent things, watch and see. You find there's a spirit of heaviness coming over you. There's fear creeping in. You're just so unhappy. You find there's strife following you because that's the demonic that you've opened the door to just by watching those things. I want to assure you, there's a lot of healthy content, good, godly Christian content that you can dwell on, and it will feed your spirit and it will grow you. So let's make it a point to throw this filthy stuff out. And this is what David says. I refuse to gaze on that which is vulgar. I despise works of evil people and anything that moves my heart away from you. I will not let evil hold me in its grip. Let's guard the eyes. Let's guard our eyes, my dear sister. Even Job said this. I think it's so cool. He said, I made a covenant with my eyes not to look lustfully at a young woman. So today, as we hit reset, I want you to make a covenant with your eyes that you will not look at anything that does not glorify your Father in heaven. If you're going to watch it, ask yourself, will my Father in heaven look down and say, oh, well done, my daughter? If you don't think you're going to get a well done, stay away from it. It is not worth your time because you're opening the door to things you know nothing about. So let's stay away from it. Amen? Then still in the area of purity of eyes and ears, music is a very, very powerful one as well. God designed music intentionally to stir up our spirit and our mind and to draw us closer to Him. That is the purpose of music, just to draw us in closer to Him, to focus on Him. That's why we do worship, you know, so that by the time we get into the Word and prayer, your spirit is attuned with the Spirit of God. You're one with Him. You're sensitive to His leading. And I trust you felt that way today when we're having our worship session. But in the same way, the enemy gets music and uses it to draw you closer to himself. I was told some music, where is Jolie? She has gone. There's some very popular music. I've now forgotten. I didn't write that down. You know that glorifies the devil, glorifies sexual sin, and, you know, things like that. And it's popular. And we sing it without knowing, without being careful about it. Do you just realize what you're doing when you're singing that music? You're opening a door to the influence of what you're singing into your life. Music is so, so critical. In the Bible, I'm reminded of Elisha. There's a time there were three kings and they were at war. And then they go to a place where there was no water and they were wondering, what do we do? And then Jehoshaphat was one of them and he said, is there not a prophet of the Lord so that we can inquire of the Lord through him? And they went to Elisha and Elisha said in 2 Kings 3:15, he said, now bring me someone who can play the harp. Music. While the harp was being played, the power of the Lord came upon Elisha and he prophesied and he told them the word of the Lord. That's how powerful music is. You know, even for you and I, if you want to draw closer to the Lord in your quiet time and all, it's a very good thing to worship Him. Because when you play the music and it's to the Lord, you worship the Lord. In the same way, between Saul and David in 1 Samuel 16:23, and it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took a harp and played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. Music is so powerful, again I say it. it is a good weapon for warfare. You're struggling with demonic oppression, with a spirit of heaviness, with confusion. You don't know what to do, whatever it is. Just play some music and worship the Lord. And He will dispel the heaviness. He will dispel the confusion. He will dispel the evil spirits. But in the same way, if you get the music of, you know, of who? You know, you get that wicked music and you start playing it, you're erecting an altar to that spirit. You're worshiping that spirit and opening yourself up to bondage, to demonic attack. I see a lot of that today. A lot of girls are in church. They love the Lord. They sing the Christian music, but they also sing the other one. And they say, but it's harmless. I'm just singing it, you know. I don't go to the nightclubs. I don't go to the bars. I'm just singing them. I mean, it's good lyrics. Good lyrics inspired by who? Whose spirit is behind those lyrics? There is no spiritual vacuum. There is a spirit behind those lyrics. So hit reset in the area of purity of eyes and ears and say, I'm saying no to anything vile. Psalms 119 verse 37 says, turn away my eyes and from looking at worthless things and revive me in your way. And I want to add, turn away my ears from listening to worthless things and revive me in your way. It's a conscious decision to turn away. You've been playing that music, stop playing it. You're in a taxi and you're captive there. Say, oh Lord, block my ears that this will not enter my heart. Make it a prayer. We can do this, there's no excuse. It is a conscious choice. Love yourself enough to guard yourself until against the evils of this world. Prefer yourself over what is popular, what seems cool. It is not taking you to heaven. Only that ancient path that the Lord marked out for us will take us to heaven. So let us guard it jealously and throw out anything that derails us from that path. Then the last area in hitting reset in the area of purity is cultural practices and rituals. Now, all of us come from different backgrounds, right? And in our backgrounds, we have different cultural things that were practiced even before we came to be. And we came into those cultures and found those things being practiced. And we have adopted some of them without even thinking through, without even knowing what they mean. Now, some are good, and some are meant to promote good things. When they say, kneel and greet your elders, it's not a bad thing, is it? It's just promoting respect. Now, I'm not saying go and kneel now. Again, I say this cultural. But it just promotes respect. Nothing wrong with that. But when the cultural practices begin to be gray and they begin to have spiritual implications, let's be careful. You've all seen babies who have beads, waist beads. Even some grown-up people have the waist beads. Even some girls in church have the waist beads. Maria, we check you. Even in church, some people put those waist beads on their kids. Now some people do use those waist beads knowingly. They know what they're up to. But there are others who do it ignorantly because that's what has always been done. I saw it then, I'm doing it now. Yeah, it's just... And then others have no clue what the real meaning behind them is. You're just saying, yeah, it's to create a waste. Why are you creating a waste for a baby who is 6 months? You know? But waste beads are symbolic for fertility, sexuality, spiritual protection and well-being from the gods. Now, let me tell you one thing. You've heard it said, ignorance is no defense. That is true even in spiritual things. Just because you have no idea what it means doesn't mean that you're exempted from the implications of that which you're partaking of. When you indulge in, like, waste beads, just because you don't know that there's sexuality and what, doesn't mean you're escaping it. The powers behind it are still operating, regardless of whether you know it or not. You get it? So, you wonder why your child at 10 years is running around with that boy, that boy, that boy, that boy. You grow up putting waste beads around them and opening them up to all these gods of sexuality and fertility. And they are calling out. So let's just be careful what we embrace in those things. If you're here today, we're going to hit reset in the area of cultural rituals and all those things. And make sure we subject them to the truth of God's word. If you're here today and you're wearing waist beads, or you have some other form, don't laugh, it is real. Or you have some other forms of charms that you're carrying, I encourage you, child of God, today, do not live here with them. Bring them. And we will burn them. We will burn them in the name of Jesus, because they have no power. Luke 10:19 tells us, in fact, starting from 10:18, Jesus said, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. That means he's defeated. And it says in 19, all authority I have given you to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the power of the enemy. And nothing, nothing will harm you. We will take them captive and subject them to the authority of God's word that is living, it is alive, it is active, it is sharper than any double-edged sword. And the word of God is like a hammer that crushes the rock to pieces. If you stand in the word of God, you have nothing to fear from the enemy. Still going in that area. There's evil covenants that we enter knowingly or unknowingly. It's become a trend, sadly, today. Fortune telling, palm reading, horoscopes, occultic practices, new age things, whatever, name it. And we go and engage ourselves in such things. Knowingly or unknowingly. Sometimes you think, oh, it's the cool thing today, the cool thing to do today. But listen, when you do that, you open the door to the enemy and you're telling him, hey, take notice, I'm interested. And he's coming your way. So if you've been opening such doors, and you know what? Your conscience is your best judge. I may not have mentioned it, but if it is not right, you will know. If you've been opening such a door, close it. Stop. Love yourself enough. Your soul is at stake. Close it and turn away from it and say, I am not having anything to do with these things. Then there's witchcraft or witchcraft. Culturally, since time immemorial, our forefathers practiced witchcraft. That was like their religion, right? And today, generations later, we get saved, we're in church, right? But depending on how rooted or unrooted you are, your background has influence on you. when push comes to shove, and you're knocking 40, you're not married. And they're saying, but you, why aren't you getting married? As we know how to fix that problem. Your elders. And they come and they pressure you because they've been telling you since you were 20, but you refuse because you are in church. But now you're 40 and they're pushing and suddenly you give in. And you go and they quish, 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 you know? You might even get the man out of that. But do you know what you have just done to yourself by engaging in witchcraft? One foot in church, one foot in witchcraft. Do you have any idea what you do to yourself? The devil is evil. There is nothing good to come from him. So don't be deceived. It might look like it's good because now you have a husband. But, oh, we hear the stories of what happens. And then when they confess and they want to get out of it, they can't because they are married to a demon now. It's not worth it. Wait on the Lord. Stick in there and wait on him. He alone knows the plan he has for us. It's a good plan. It's very critical that we hit reset in the area of these cultural practices and rituals, that we subject everything to the will of God, to the truth of God's word. It is very, very critical that as a child of God, today we hit reset. Turn away from whatever it is that doesn't honor the Lord and fix your eyes on him and say, oh Lord, I am waiting on you. And you know what? As a church, this year our theme is Awesome God, Do It Again. And as we carry that posture, and we lift our hands to him and say, Awesome God, do it again. It's very important that you and I align ourselves the right way with our Lord. Where we have veered off, we course correct. If we are going to see him do it again in our lives, he will, but we must repent and turn away from anything that has derailed us from the course he marked out for us. So even as I wind down, we have just said, hit reset mentally. Make a conscious decision to reject the lies of Satan and feed on the truth of God's word. Hit reset emotionally. Let go of those pains and wounds and look to the Lord for healing and forgive and let go of bitterness and repent before him and he will heal you. Hit reset culturally. Turn away from all those wicked things and look to the Lord. As I wind down and thinking about hitting reset, really you cannot hit reset mentally or emotionally or culturally without first hitting reset spiritually. It all starts with you making it right with God. So I want to ask you today, are you walking right before God? Psalms 139 verse 23 and 24 says, search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any offensive way in me and lead me in the way everlasting. Right now, I want us to take time ask the Lord to search you. Ask the Lord to search you. If there's anything the Lord lays on your heart that is not right, it may not even be in the areas I've talked about, because like I said, there's so much. But whatever the Lord lays on your heart that's standing in the way of you and Him, repent. Repent, my sister, and lay it down, lay it aside. Loving Father, we come before you today, acknowledging that we are sinners, that we have strayed from you in one way or another. And Lord, even as you search our hearts, you have showed us those areas where we have strayed away from you. Lord, today, we're here to say we're sorry. Forgive us, Lord, for compromising. Forgive us, Lord, for choosing the easy way out. Forgive us, Lord, for ignoring the truth of God's word and pursuing the pleasures of the flesh. Forgive us, Lord, for grieving your heart, O Lord. We are sorry. And we ask you, Lord, have mercy on us. Today we choose to hit reset by carrying all those sins and burdens and pains and struggles and placing them at the foot of your cross, because right there we hit reset in the name of Jesus. We lay it all at your feet and we ask you, Lord, wash us clean with the precious blood of Jesus. Make us new, make us whole again. In Jesus' name, amen. But you might also be here, and as I'm talking about child of God and all these other things, you have never made a decision to follow Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Hit reset starts there. It starts with a personal relationship with Jesus. So, with every head bowed and every eye closed, if you're in this place, out in the tent, online, if you're here and you have never made a decision to follow Jesus Christ, today is your day. You will not leave here the same. So I ask you, lift your hand to Jesus and say yes to him. Say, today I choose to follow you, Jesus, as my Lord and Savior. And there's a friend of mine who will come up to you and give you a booklet and walk with you through it. But if you're here, I will call again, and you've never said yes to Jesus, lift your hand to Jesus. You're not lifting it to me, you're lifting it to Jesus. Lift your hand to Jesus. I'll wait because you're too precious to God to go away from here without entering into a personal relationship with him. Anyone? Okay. Lord, you know the hearts of your daughters. You know where they're at. Lord, for anyone who's in this place and has not accepted you as their Lord and Savior, convict them of sin and judgment, Lord. Convict them that they will make a decision to follow you today, that they will not live here without accepting you as their Lord and Savior and starting a new journey with you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, because it's all about hitting reset, and I've kind of rushed through all this, I don't want us to leave with all this stirred up in us, and then we just go. So we're going to have a time of prayer now. And we are going to pray through these areas. And I'm going to invite a few friends of mine, Debbie, to lead us in the different areas of prayer. And, you know, just give your heart to Jesus. And let's leave this place different than we came in. Let's leave this place different than we came in. Debbie. Because the Bible says that the prayer of a righteous woman is powerful and effective, and it avails much. So even as we pray, let's believe and have the faith, because God is up to some amazing things in our midst today. Amen?
Let's rise up. Thank you so much, Vanita. I believe that someone has touched most of us. I believe God has spoken to all of us. And I believe as Vanita was preaching, some of those things resonated to you, or to the people that you love, or to the people that you care about, or the people that you have seen in the community. Most of us, we've heard about things to do with our mental health. And our mental health has discouraged most of us. It has not been good. We have heard of depression. We have heard of those situations that we have born with. Alcoholism has led us into a bad mental health situation. Drug addiction. There's so much. Each one of us knows someone, at least, who has had a mental issue.
I want us to call upon the name of the Lord. I want us to call upon God on behalf of the people that you know, even those that are not so close to you, even if it is you or your loved one. I want you to close your eyes. Don't look at your neighbor. We came to hit reset. Today we want to hit reset on our mental health. As ladies, we get burdened by so many things. We have so many cares that have taken us away from God. We worry about the clothes to put on. We worry about our children, which schools they will go to. We worry about getting married. We worry about our careers. We worry about so much, and it has weighed us down that sometimes we can't even think beyond where we are, that sometimes we can't even sleep. Sometimes we can't even have a meal and it goes down in our stomachs. And sometimes the meal is not even there. Ladies, we are known to worry. We are known to carry burdens. So today I want us to reset and surrender all those burdens to God, because God is the only one that can help you. God is the only one that can put you in a right set of mind. If you surrender those worries to Him, don't look at me, don't look at your neighbor, don't worry about anything. It is time to reset our minds and go back to God. Father, we give you glory. We thank you because you care about each and every one of us, oh God. We thank you because you love us with an everlasting love, oh God. Father, we surrender our minds to you today, oh God. A lot has taken us up, oh God, that we have even forgotten that you are there, that you care, that you tell us to cast our burdens upon you, oh God. So today, Lord, we choose to surrender to you. We choose to lay our cares and burdens to you. Father, in the book of Matthew 11, 28, you tell us, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Come to God. Woman of God, child of God, come to God. Surrender all your cares. Surrender all your burdens to God. And let Him take charge of your life. Let Him take charge of that mental situation in the name of Jesus. Lord, we come against a spirit of depression that has overtaken us, oh God, that has made us think about committing suicide, oh God, because of the cares of this world that have taken up our minds, that have taken up our thinking. Lord, we come against PTSD, oh God. Lord, we come against alcoholism, oh God. We come against schizophrenia, oh God. We come against autism, my master. Lord, none of your children should have those mental situations, oh God. Father, alcoholism has taken over our loved ones. We see them suicidating on themselves on the streets. We see them failing to take care of their lives and the people that are in their care. Father, alcoholism has taken over our people. Drugs have conquered us. They have taken over our loved ones, our children, our spouses, our siblings. Lord, today we declare that they are free, oh God, because we choose to bring our burdens to you. We choose to labor no more, because in you the burden is light and the yoke is easy. So we surrender them to you, Father, right now. Father, we know that our mind is for you. We set our minds on the things of God right now, oh God. We ask, oh God, that whatever we have consumed that has disturbed our minds, that has distorted our thinking, that has distorted the neurons in our brains, that has distorted the nerves in our brains, Lord, may you fix it in the name of Jesus. We surrender our minds to you. Child of God, hold your mind and start to speak sense. Start to speak stability. Start to speak freedom in that mind of yours, even right now, in the name of Jesus. Even if it is not you, even if it is on behalf of someone else, speak deliverance. Touch your brain and speak healing to our autistic children. Lord, we bring them to you, my master. Lord, they are not supposed to be like that. We surrender their minds, oh God. We surrender their systems to you in the name of Jesus. You are the one that created us, my King. You are the one that can fix us, oh God. So Lord, may you fix your sons and daughters today. May we fix our eyes on you, oh God. May we not fix our eyes on the things of this world that burden us, that weigh us down, in the name of Jesus. May our mental health be free. May our mental health be revived. May our mental health be restored, oh God, to fullness, to full functionality, in the name of Jesus. Lord, may we feed on only that which gives glory and honor to your name, that which is going to work on our mental health and help us to be better. Lord, Lord, we shall not be in hospital taking medicines because of depression. We shall not be in hospital taking medicines because we are running mad. Lord, we are not going to take those antidepressants in the name of Jesus. We are not going to take all the normal medications. But Lord, you are going to heal us today and now in the name of Jesus. We call upon your Spirit. Spirit of God, may you shine upon us. Spirit of God, may you come and deliver us. Spirit of God, may you come and set your daughters free right now in the name of Jesus. May you take captive of our minds. May you take captive of our thoughts. May you take captive of everything that weighs us down, oh God. We know that you are the God of impossibles, oh God. This is nothing to you, oh God. This is nothing to you, my master. You can do all things, oh God. You are the God that rescues. You're the God that put our bodies in place. You're the God that put our minds in place, oh God. Even right now, God, renew our minds, oh God, as we hit reset to start reading your word, to start praying, to watch good music, to listen to good music and watch good movies, oh God. Lord, may you work on our mental health. May it be revived, my master. May it be renewed, my master. We surrender it to you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we surrender our loved ones, oh God. Those in Ibutabika right now, oh God. Those in hospitals admitted because of mental health issues, oh Lord. We surrender them to you and we command them to rise up right now in Jesus' name. To be stable, to be able to move, to be able to think right, oh God. May you put all the nerves together. May you put all the neurons together that they will function the way they are meant to function, oh God. Father, we are not scientists because you're greater than science. And it is you we call upon. It is you that we lean on. It is you that we depend on. It is you that we cry out, oh God. Father, we have come to hit reset. May you hit reset in our lives. May you hit reset in our mental health. May you hit reset in our loved ones' lives. We are not here on our own. We are here because you have chosen us. But we stand in the gap of the rest that are not here, that need that healing, that need that revival, that need that refilling, that need that freedom in the name of Jesus. Free us, oh God. Free us, oh God, that we worship you from a clean heart. That we worship you from a clean heart, oh God. Free us, Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that when we come to you, oh God, we receive our healing. Thank you that when we come to you, oh God, you revive us, oh my master. Thank you that when we come to you, you come through for us, oh God. So right now, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that you've already come through for us. That you've already delivered, God. That you've already set your children free. That you have already set the captives free. The captives to bad mental health, oh God, they have been set free in the name of Jesus. And Father, we declare that when we leave this place, we shall take care of our mental health. We shall read what is good. We shall watch what is good. We shall feed on what is righteous, oh God. That we shall learn to lay our burdens unto you. When the cares come our way, oh God, we shall choose to leave them at your feet. We shall choose to leave them with you because you are the only one that can fix them. So Father, forgive us for thinking we are in control. Forgive us for thinking that we have charge over everything. Forgive us for thinking that you are less than. Forgive us for thinking that we can handle it on our own, because clearly we cannot handle it on our own. Help us today, oh God. Help us today, oh God, and hear the cry of our children. Hear the cry of your daughters. We bless you, King Jesus, because that we know that in you there is fullness of life, oh God. In you there is fullness of joy, oh God. There is joy in our brains. There is peace in our brains. There is happiness in our brains. There is love in our brains. There is surrender in our brains. There is everything good in our brains from today onwards. We bless you, King Jesus. We bless you, King Jesus, and receive that which you have prepared for us, oh God. Amen. You.
than able. Do you believe that God is more than able? Don't just say it, believe it. We are going to reset emotionally. We are emotional beings. We ladies are emotional beings. So we are going to do something that is not very conventional. I want you to touch your heart. You know where your heart is? Hebrews 12:15. See to it that no one falls short of the grace of God, and that no bitter root grows up to the cause, trouble and defile many. Right now, I want us to touch our hearts. Don't look at anyone. Close your eyes. It's only you and our God. It's only you and Jesus. Hold that heart. And I want you to ask Holy Spirit to search those negative emotions. Unforgiveness is like a seed. It's like a seed that grows and will destroy a whole vine. Bitterness is a root that does not go anywhere. It grows and spreads in everything. Shame. Maybe you are ashamed today of what you've done. The enemy will bring shame. He'll bring guilt. He'll bring bitterness, anger, rage. So I would like you to just take 1 minute. Search. May the Holy Spirit begin to search your heart right now. Ask Him and say, I don't even know if I did anything. Maybe I'm innocent. For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. None of us are innocent in any way, but Jesus took everything on the cross. So take 1 minute and just ask Holy Spirit to search for where there is bitterness, anger, unforgiveness, rage, jealousy, shame, and guilt. I know that even as you're thinking about it, the enemy is telling you, no, you're perfect. The enemy is telling you that, no, it's okay. It's okay to keep the anger. Anger feels sweet. Unforgiveness feels sweet. Do not allow the enemy to deceive you. And even as you think about it and allow the enemy, don't allow the enemy to deceive you. Ask for forgiveness. The word of God reminds us that when we forgive, He will forgive. Forgive those who have hurt you. Let it go. Let it go. Mention the names of those people that you're angry at, those that you have not forgiven, those that you have rage to, those who have caused pain. It may be all kinds of pain. When this little girl shared and said, you know, I was left to be a parent at an early age, it wasn't something easy. What is that bitterness, the root of unforgiveness? And when the Lord has revealed it, I know that He has, because Holy Spirit will not just let it go. He wants you to let it go. It's difficult. It's the hardest thing to do, to let it go. But today, ask Jesus to teach you how to forgive. Man may teach you what forgiveness is, but ask Jesus to teach you how to forgive. I want you to mention it with your lips. Say it. Don't look at me. Just connect with your Father in heaven and ask Him and say, Daddy, I do not know how to forgive. I do not know how to let go of this bitterness. I do not know how to let go of this anger. Teach me, and He will come, because the presence of the Lord is already here. Ask Him. Ask Him. Sisters, ask Him.
our Daddy, our Heavenly Father. Today we come as your children, your daughters, your princesses, your queens. We are children of the Most High God. And I want you to believe that you are. And because you're a child of the Most High God, He hears you. He hears you. He hears that cry. Lord, you forgave us at the cross. And we shall indeed never understand and know the price of the cross. But today, as we come as sisters, not just to celebrate, but to come before your throne of grace, just as we are, sitting at your feet, basking in your love and in your presence, and asking that you will teach us how to forgive, to let go. Remove that root of bitterness, of anger, of rage, of jealousy. And we ask, oh God, that you shall replace it with your love. I know that there are some ladies who may say, you're praying Father and saying, Father, is he really my father? It's that father who hurt me. And yes, your father may have hurt you. And you're in pain, so much pain that can never be understood. And yet we've got a Heavenly Father who loves so much, and he loves you. And today he's saying, I love you, and I want you to let go. Do not be ashamed. Shame is not of God. Guilt is not of God, because Jesus took everything at the cross. My sisters, think of those names. Think of those people, your past, the situations, even when you're jealous on behalf of another person. But the word of God reminds us to let go of all bitterness, all anger. Let go and allow Jesus to take your emotions. So I would like you to ask him personally and tell him, please take this emotion that I do not understand. You may have even thoughts and saying, why do I exist on this planet? Why was I born? But Psalm 139 reminds us that before you were even created, he knew you. He knew you by name. He formed you. So ask him. Ask him. And you, because girls, we are very emotional. Cry if you have to cry. Don't hold those tears. Cry and say, Daddy, I've been holding on for too long. Release and let it go today. He loves you so much. Thank you, Father, for loving us. Jesus, we want to say thank you that you took up all these emotions. You took up everything. Once we were yet sinners, but you died for us. Who are we indeed? Who is man that you are mindful of him? But you died for us. And I want to say thank you, Lord, that even today we are leaving this place forgiven, but also we have forgiven. We are leaving this place free, that our hearts are free and we are basking in your love. We are not going to hold on to bitterness, onto anger, onto resentment, onto rage, jealousy. There is no shame, there is no more condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Lord, we love you. We thank you for your faithfulness. You are always good. You are always faithful. You are always loving. And we just want to worship you. In Jesus' name. Jesus, we thank you. We are desperate for you today. We are desperate for you as your daughters. We are desperate for you, oh God. We need more of you. God, we want to thank you for your word that has been shared, oh God. Father, we pray that as we come before your presence, the area of sexual purity, that Holy Spirit, you do something new in us, oh God. Sisters, I recognize that in different ways, you and I have failed God in the area of sexual purity. Our bodies are temples of the Holy, of God. But sometimes we've allowed ourselves to get dragged into the filth of pornography, extramarital relationships. Some of us have got involved in lesbianism, in masturbation. Sex is God's gift in marriage. So any form of sex out of marriage is sin. Sex with yourself is masturbation. Sex with a fellow lady is lesbianism. Sex with a married man is adultery. So if in any way pornography opens you up, you know, to sexual activity, may not be physical, but your whole being is involved. So we're going to take time to repent and say, God, you know me. You know the things I've done in the dark, the websites I have searched. You know what I'm struggling with. Some of us experience sexual dreams. And maybe you think it's spiritual. Yes, it's very spiritual. But is it of God? No. Because if you open up doors and windows in our lives, then demonic activity is going to start happening. Like Pastor Vanessa shared with us, if we sleep around, sex is not just physical, sex is also spiritual. So in a way, some of us, you've had one relationship after another, slept with every boyfriend, sexual network. And so we are struggling with things. But God is saying today, as we hit reset, he's saying forget the former things. God wants to do something new. So you want to go into the presence of God in repentance and say, God, forgive me. God, cleanse me. God, wash me in the blood of Jesus. Jesus paid the price once and once for all. And you and I only have to receive our forgiveness and walk out in victory. Because believe me, yes, you can.
You and I can do all things. We can live in sexual purity. If we are single, we can remain virgins up to our wedding day. If we are married, we can remain faithful to our spouses by the grace of God. So let's take time and just go into a time of repentance, and then we'll read a scripture from 1 Corinthians. Let's just take time to just pray. God, we come before you at this time, oh God, and we recognize that we have sinned against you in our thoughts, in our words, in what we have done, in what we have failed to do. Forgive us, oh Lord, where we've engaged in all kinds of wrong sexual behaviors. Forgive us for masturbation. Forgive us, oh God, for lesbianism. Forgive us, oh God, for adultery, for fornication. God, some of us are flattered with our classmates, with our lecturers, with our bosses at work, and God, we know it is wrong. I ask that God today, oh God, you'll forgive us and cleanse us. Wash us in the blood of Jesus. Holy Spirit, do a new work today. Sisters, you're here and you're struggling. There's guilt and there's shame. God is saying today he has come to remove that shame, remove that pain, remove that past. God wants to wash you clean today. He wants to start a new page, to turn a new page in your life. Just call out on the Lord. Let's cry out to God and say, God, start with me. Cleanse me. David said in Psalms 51, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit. Let's cry out to the Lord. Call out to the Lord in repentance. Out to the Lord, my sister. You know the area you're struggling with in terms of sexual sin. Today, God is setting us free. Say, Lord, do it in my life. Yes, break those strongholds in my mind, in my body. Yes, today, those friends, oh God, that you know you have walked with and you know they are wrong influence today. So, God, I choose to part company from this wrong company. Oh, of God tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 15 to 20. It says, do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ himself? Shall I then take the members of Christ and unite them with a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that he who unites himself or herself with a prostitute is one with her in body? For it is said that two will become one flesh. But whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit. Flee from sexual immorality. All other sins a person commits are outside the body, but whoever sins sexually sins against their own body. Do you not know that your bodies, my sister, are temples of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. Beautiful as we are, amazing as we are, you are not your own. Each one of us, you were bought at a price. It cost Jesus something, his life. He gave his all so that you and I could have life and have eternal life. So the Bible is saying, therefore, honor God with your bodies. Honor God with your bodies. So even as we talk about breaking from sexual sin,
we need to recognize that these bodies, we are only stewards. God created each one of us beautiful, amazing. But many of us have gone as ahead and broken that trust and gone our own ways. But today, as we hit reset, we are saying, God, I rededicate myself back to you. I rededicate my mind, my body, my emotions. I know as ladies, every month we have the cycle and it comes with different, you know, desires. You find that you've been living upright, but of a sudden you're so cautious of your male colleague next, on the next door. We have to just be aware. It's time for the cycle, practice self-control and move on. That's not a time to go out for coffee dates or free lunches or take free lifts home, because the potential of weight ending in the wrong place is very high. So let's also be aware. The Bible says we're no longer ignorant, you know. Now that you know, you're able to do things differently. So even as we pray, yes, we've asked God to forgive us of our sins, but we also going to pray that God is going to break those bondages. For those of us who, as we, Pastor Valentine was sharing, through cultural practices, some of us, from when we were born, our umbilical cords were taken to the wrong place. The address was wrong, and since then, you wonder what is happening. Yes, you're not getting married. You're having all these sexual dreams. You get proposals, but just before the engagement, just before the introduction, just before the wedding, something happens and it's canceled. Once is a chance. Twice or thrice, there's a pattern. Today we are saying, God, that pattern ends today. Jesus said he came to set the captives free. So maybe it's you, maybe it's a friend you know, maybe a workmate you know. Let's rise up on our feet and believe God that today all those cultural practices end in the past, that God is setting us free, that weddings will start in your home. People will go to campus and graduate. People will have children. Some of us, those practices have stopped us from having babies, and we are saying, what is wrong? God is saying today he wants to set us free. Let's call on the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you. We bless your wonderful name, because indeed you are says, he whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And Lord God, this afternoon, O God, we want to renounce, O God, every covenant that we have made on our behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus, we cancel them. We render them powerless in Jesus' name. Father, we decree and declare, Lord God, that yes, we shall live a life of holiness. We shall live a life of sexual purity. We are praying, my Father, Lord God, that we are covenants we have made, O Lord God. Yes, through aunties, O God, through witch doctors, O Lord God.